Why should I consume anything which is damaging for me? Why should I consume anything which does not allow me to be happy? There is a difference between tasty food and healthy food. Similarly, there's a difference between tasty information and healthy information. For a few days, I have to pay attention to shift to taste from tasty to healthy. But after a few days, I will not be able to take that tasty information. The few days needed to shift, after that it won't be a diet. It will be my natural way of living. What happens when we read, watch, or listen about something that's happening in some part of the world? What happens in that part of the world creates pain. And so there's pain circulating in the world vibrations. The rest of the world only reads and watches about it and creates pain. And so then what happens to the vibrations of the world? The pain level intensifies. When there was no media giving us world information, pain was restricted to 5 people, 10 people, 50 people. But today, because information reaches within 5 minutes all over the world, now how many people are creating the pain? How many people are creating the pain? So hatred for the one who did it, pain for the one who is suffering. How many people are creating that hatred and pain? At least 50% of the world population. And that is because of that, that the world vibrations is now vibrating at fear. If you don't consume the pain. And if you don't consume what's happening, you are already vibrating at compassion. Right now, if you don't consume anything which is at a lower frequency, you're already vibrating at a higher frequency. So let's say, okay, let's take it in this hall of 800 people. She gets hurt. Now, once she gets hurt, she's in pain. So one person in pain, 799 people in peace and purity and positivity. The vibration in the whole will help to heal her. But if she's in pain and just looking at her in pain, if 799 people also, ay, kya hua, kya hua, kya hua, kya hua, kya hua, kaise hua, oh Baba, I'm also crying, I can feel your pain, I'm in more pain than you. Hota hai, nahi hota? Then this hall will be vibrating at pain. And when that happens, what will happen to this sister? What will happen to that sister? Her pain will get reinforced. That's what's happening in the world. So even if I come to know something, then if I read it and watch it, I will have to take care that where am I vibrating? each soul has an original sanskar of purity, original sanskar of power, original sanskar of peace, original sanskar of happiness, original sanskar of bliss. But why are we not experiencing it today? Because we have consumed the vibrations of other people around us. If I just protect myself from others' vibrations, I will be influencing them with my vibration. So even if your child is in pain, advice cannot heal them. But what can heal them? Advice cannot heal people always. Suppose she says, you know what happened in college, and I will say, don't worry, everything will okay. Huh? It's not going to make any difference. And the daughter is only going to look at you and you don't even know how much pain I am in. Advice cannot heal people always. But there is one thing which can heal people. What's that one thing? Your vibrations can heal people. ever experienced walking into a temple or a church or a meditation center where you just walk in and you feel nice? Who's experienced that walking in, being there, feeling nice? What happened to us? A higher vibration influenced my state of mind, and I have the sanskar of peace. The higher vibration of that place triggered my sanskar of peace, and I say, I'm feeling at peace. That higher vibration need not always be a temple or a church. That higher vibration can be we for people around us. Your child can just come and sit next to you, not say anything, but just be next to you and say, okay, mom, now I'm feeling better and I'm going back. But sometimes the parent is in more pain than the child. And the child will say, mom, please go out, lock the door, leave me alone. Hota hai? Because when I am in pain, I don't want to sit next to anybody who is also in pain. Even if that somebody is my own parent. I don't want to, because I just can't handle any more pain right now. But if my parent or my spouse or my child is vibrating at a higher frequency, I will just go and sit next to them and say, they will say, do you want to talk about something? They say, no, I don't want to talk about anything. Because they know that even if they talk about it, you can't do anything about it. They have to sort out their own problem. But what will they get just by being with us? That same energy what we get when we go to a temple or to a church. What creates the vibration of the temple and the church? Who creates the vibration? Who creates the vibration? We create the vibration, because when we go there, we are not talking about world news. We're talking about studying about, thinking about God, love, compassion, purity, unity. It's in the air. Can my house be like that? Can my house be like that? Yes? Can my office be like that? And most important, can I be a walking radiator of peace? Yes? We all carry an energy field. Do you ever feel the vibes of people around you? Do you feel sometimes I'm not comfortable with this person? They're being very nice, behaving very nice, perfect behavior. I'm not comfortable sitting next to this person. What is not comfortable? What is not comfortable? That energy field. And what is the energy field created out of? Every thought, every feeling, every intention, every memory. So if I'm holding on to worry, fear, anger, hatred, past, my energy field is very heavy. Very heavy. I am a walking, talking radiator of heavy energy. But if I cleanse myself daily, pure, decluttered, I am a walking, talking radiator of purity and peace. And that's the biggest gift we can give to family and friends, a pure, high frequency vibration energy field. Want to create a high energy field? Want to create a high energy field? And which means we will be vibrating at which frequency? Okay, let's check the frequency of some words. Fear. Fear. Hurt, insulted, disrespected, rejected, depressed. We know it all. Why are we living there? You know why we're living there? Because we said, I did not create it. It was because of, like sister said, I get irritated because of. Check on your list. Because of, fill in the blank, how many names are there for which we say, I feel like this because of. If I talk that language, I will live like a victim for the rest of my life. Who is the creator of my feelings? Who is the creator of my feelings? Can anyone create my hurt for me? Sure. Can anyone hurt me? Hanji? Can I hurt you right now? You want to try? Think about it. How many times we've said, even if it was just internally, you hurt me. You insulted me. Do we say this? What are we saying at that time? What am I saying? You hurt me. You irritated me. You upset me. What's the meaning? That what I'm feeling here? Mummy even says to the beta, na? Does she ever say to you, don't irritate me? We say it to people, don't irritate me. They can't irritate us. They can only do what they're doing. But what did we do it? We connected both of it, and the emotion that I created in response to their behavior, I did not say I was creating that emotion. I said they are creating this emotion for me. Only one mistake changed the vocabulary, changed the way of living. So my child is not studying, my child is not cleaning up the room, my child is not getting up and getting ready to school. And for every line I said, don't irritate me, don't irritate me, don't irritate me. They were not irritating me, they were only not studying. But when they were not studying, I was creating irritation. But I did not say I was creating irritation. I said they irritated me. Any difference between the two things? Any difference or same thing? Just a jugglery of words. What difference they did or I did? I got irritated when they didn't study. Any difference between the two things? Don't irritate me. Don't irritate me. What does it mean? I'm going to look at you and say, don't irritate me. What does it mean? Every time I say this line, and I must be saying this line many times during one single day. Every time I'm saying this line, I'm reaffirming my faith. People create my emotions and feelings. And every time I reaffirm this, people create my emotions and feelings, I reaffirm I can be happy only when the world is perfect. And perfect also according to? Perfect to hai wo, lekin perfect according to me. Which might not ever happen. And then being happy might not ever happen. Only because of one line. You irritate me. You upset me. You hurt me. You did not study. You did not wish me on my birthday. You did not behave right. Fine, you did not behave right. But you did not hurt me. You did not behave right. Who created the hurt? You did not behave right. You abused me. You used wrong language. Who created the hurt? I created the hurt. One is giving the power away, and one is taking the power and saying, I created the hurt. Second line, how long do I want to be hurt? Choose. But if I say you hurt me, then how long am I going to be hurt? How long am I going to be hurt? Till you apologize or till you change? Which might happen tomorrow and which might not happen ever. Only because I used one wrong line, you hurt me. And only if I change that line, I said, they behaved this way, I created the hurt. I have a choice how much to hurt and for how long to hurt. Do we have a choice? Do we have a choice? And who will heal me? Who will heal me? Because if I say you hurt me, now you have to heal me. But if I say I created the hurt, then who will heal me? Myself. Life becomes so simple. Just take one equation today with you. Nothing and no one can create anything here for me. They can create everything outside for me. They can cheat me. They can even hit me. But they can't hurt me. They can't hurt me. They can hit me, but they can't hurt me. Because nobody can get inside here. We gave up power over our own mind only because of this one line. You did this, you did this, you did this, you did. One line, I am creating this, everything will change. I am a powerful soul. And I create my every thought and feeling. And I have a choice what to create when they behave the way they behave. So even if I created hurt today, I have a choice what to create tomorrow. Even if I created irritation today, I have a choice what to create tomorrow. But if they irritated me, I have no choice tomorrow. So the title is to choose happiness. Choose, even if they behave the way they behave. Do you know the babies didn't leave the room? They didn't. I requested 5 times. Ho gaya kaam. After that, I have to choose happiness. I have to. Because if I'm happy, then my happy vibrations will radiate to that baby. Otherwise, I will sit with those people in the same hall for the rest of my life and radiate hurt to them. And we radiate hurt to people whom we claim to love the most. Only because we are creating hurt because of a certain behavior of theirs. And we can create the hurt, create the worry, create the insecurity, live in the same house and radiate that energy to them every day. Do we worry for our children and family? How many of you know how to worry? Frequency? Worry. Frequency? Frequency? Worry. Low? High? Worry. Frequency? Worry, frequency. Care, frequency. Concern, frequency. Worry. See the difference. You can see it and how it feels. And every time the mind creates a thought which is at a lower frequency, sit back with it for 2 minutes. Teach it the right way of thinking. That's meditation. Meditation is to not allow the baby to continue crying. You know, visualize a baby in the cradle at home and the mother taking care of everything else at home. Can she do both the things, take care of the baby and take care of all the other work at home? Can she do both the things? Can she do both the things? Yes? So she will take care of all the other work at home, but who will be the first priority? Baby. So if the baby starts crying, what's the mother going to do? Withdraw from what I'm doing, go up to the baby for 20 seconds, back to work. Baby. If this baby starts crying, withdraw from what you are doing for 20 seconds. But if I don't withdraw, just to go and do this to the baby, baby will keep crying. And now today we say stress is natural. Which means crying baby is natural. And suppose one day the baby does not cry, we say something is wrong, the baby is not crying. Yes. Because I've got so used to that volume of my mind inside, chatter, 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 chatter. And that's why sometimes when we come to the center in the beginning and there's so much silence, stillness, some people feel very uncomfortable. Because they've just not been silent for a very, very long time. But that's not good for my mind, and that's not good for my body, and that's not good for my relationships. So if this baby starts crying, withdraw 20 seconds. What happened? She said this to me. Talk to it for 20 seconds. She's not happy, she's unwell, she's upset, so she behaved that way. She's not going to behave the way I want her to be every time. Don't allow this baby to start saying, she doesn't love me, she doesn't respect me. It's like one vocabulary which is going on inside. Anything people do which is not our way, they don't love me, they don't respect me, they don't value me. It goes on talking. Stop it and teach it another way of thinking. They don't love me, say I love them. They don't respect me, I respect them. Don't allow it to continue crying. Otherwise, I shift from being a master over myself to being a victim. Victim. Bichari mein. Victim. And sometimes people around me endorse my victim feeling. Poor you. The people who endorse my victim feeling are not family and friends. But because they are not master over themselves, they endorse the victim feeling.